When you hear hurricanes coming your way, you probably gotta stay indoors or evacuate. Your flight, definitely getting canceled. But for some people, the news of a hurricane means that it's time to take off. See, while satellites can spot storms when they form and track their location, if you want more detail, there's no substitute for getting up close and personal. That's why the US National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration and other agencies fly planes directly into these storms. And as the storms get more common and extreme with climate change, I'm not sure who would volunteer for that job.
Tell me about it.
Oh, hello. It's our friend Maiya from the PBS series Weathered. Maiya, you have been covering climate change for years on your show. Can you please take over this episode and explain to everyone how these brave people do this?
Sure, Hank. Get ready for an adventure that involves 180 mile per hour winds, flying sideways into the eye of a hurricane, and two very tough planes named Kermit and Miss Piggy. Okay, before I can tell you about hurricane hunters, I need to explain a few things about hurricanes. You're probably familiar with the satellite imagery of big swirling clouds around a well-defined eye. Hurricanes can be more than 15,000 meters tall, and the storms can build for days before they reach hurricane status. The clouds you see in the satellite images are called central dense overcast, and they cover up what's going on inside. Moving inward, you'll find rain bands that circle the center of the storm. And the strongest, windiest band, the eye wall, surrounds the eye of the storm. The eye forms over a central low pressure zone. We might like to call things as light as air, but air has weight. On average, there are about 14.7 pounds of air per square inch at sea level, pressing down on what's below. This pressure is also called one atmosphere, or 1,013.25 millibars. However, it's possible to get an unstable column of warm air where the pressure is lower than its surroundings. So air rushes into that zone, trying to bring it all back to equilibrium. It looks like water swirling as it goes down a drain. High ocean surface temperatures can provide enough energy for this process to continue and intensify, and sooner or later, you've got yourself a hurricane. For example, the lowest pressure recorded during Hurricane Harvey in 2017 was 937 millibars. How do we know that? Well, a group of scientists flew straight into the storm to find out. Obviously, you can't just ride any aircraft into a hurricane. You need something special, something a little tougher than the rest. You need a couple of surveillance planes named Miss Piggy and Kermit. Yes. Really. NOAA acquired these planes in the 1970s, around the time when they also took over the hurricane hunting duty from the US Navy. This type of plane, called the P-3 Orion, was originally designed for long endurance flights over the ocean. So they're built for long trips and challenging weather, and carry lots of sensors to boot. And there's also a third plane in the hurricane hunting crew. A Gulfstream jet that flies high over hurricanes and has an unusual nose. So of course, they named it Gonzo. And with regular maintenance at NOAA's Aircraft Operations Center, these planes can fly into hurricanes again and again without breaking a sweat. Then there's the people inside the planes. Each hurricane hunter flight carries a team of pilots, engineers, and scientists who brave the storm. During an 8-hour flight, they can cross into the eye of the storm as many as 4 times. They fly at an altitude of about 3,000 meters, which is relatively low. So when they hit the wall of the eye of the storm, they're getting some fantastic data about the most intense winds, the health of the storm, and whether it's getting stronger or weaker over time. And for about 40 minutes, they're also flying through some of the most intense, extreme turbulence you can imagine. Pilot Megan Gaston described it as a roller coaster going through a car wash, which is a pretty mild way to describe being thrown almost 500 meters up in just a few seconds. Meteorologist Jason Dunyan compared it to the acceleration that astronauts feel during a rocket launch, 3 to 4 G's pushing you into your seat. Other times, you might get a few seconds of weightlessness. That's what can happen when you fly into the 160-plus mile-per-hour winds of a Category 5 hurricane. Although, you can't actually fly straight through winds like that. To reach the eye of the storm, pilots have to turn the plane at an angle and fly nearly sideways through the eye wall, nose into the wind. They call it crabbing, which is an adorable name for something so terrifying. Hurricane hunters might fly into the same storm up to 6 days in a row, gathering that all-important data. The planes have some sensors built in, like Doppler radar that shoots microwaves out into the storm to measure where it's moving and how dense it is. That can tell if the storm is stable and ready to intensify, or if it's sloppy and getting weaker. A laser on board can measure temperature, humidity, and droplets in the atmosphere directly below the aircraft, all the way to the ocean surface, which gives us an idea of how the air is feeding the storm. But some other sensors need to be even closer to the action, so they get dropped out of the plane. These include dropsondes, which are these tubes a bit bigger than a paper towel roll, and they're full of sensors that are also equipped with little parachutes. Dropsondes radio transmit data like pressure, humidity, temperature, and wind speed back to the scientists on the plane as they fall. Another drop sensor, bathythermographs, send back ocean temperature data, which can help predict what will happen to the storm as it moves along. Ocean temperature data is especially crucial for understanding whether a hurricane will strengthen. Heat energy from warm water powers the storm and allows it to develop and intensify, while cooler water denies the storm of the juice that it needs and can be a good sign of a weakening storm. And considering that NOAA has been chasing hurricanes for over 50 years, it's no surprise that they're finding new ways to gather more and better data from these hair-raising flights. A smaller version of the drop sonde, called the stream sonde, can be deployed in greater numbers to gather even more data. And researchers at NOAA are finding ways to use a fleet of uncrewed vehicles like flying drones, sailing drones, and even underwater gliders to gather more data from the most turbulent part of the storm. The more data that the hurricane hunters collect, the better the National Hurricane Center gets at predicting where the storm will make landfall and how strong it will be when it gets there. And that helps folks on land to figure out where to order evacuations and where to prepare emergency services to respond when the storm moves on. In other words, hurricane hunters fly to the center of storms mostly so everyone else can get safely out of the way. So Hank, what do you say? You want to join them on their next bumpy flight?
I think I'm going to leave this one to the experts. I get motion sick on the swings. But thank you, Maiya. Be sure to check out Weathered Earth's Extremes, available to watch now on the PBS app and on PBS stations around the country. We'll put a link in the description below. Thanks for watching.